वैष्णव जन तो तेरे घरी पीर पराई जाने रे, वैष्णव जन तो तेरे कहिए।
एनी सिविलाइज्ड सोसाइटी हैज टू डेवलप मैकेनिज्म्स to support the weaker constituents. The law of the jungle is not a law for human beings. And society without compassion is a bleak one indeed. The wide variety of efforts by so many individuals and institutions that we are privileged to become familiar with while deciding on the General Al-Bajaj Awards convinces me, that compassion and the willingness and desire to work for the benefit of others are traditions that are very much alive in our great country. But history tells us that poverty is removed by expanding opportunities, by encouraging the competent and the vigorous so that employment opportunities get created. In spite of that, even when we support those activities and such people, there is need for remedial action by the government, by the state, to provide the basics to everyone, especially to the weaker sections. Education, especially primary education, health, safe drinking water, and sanitation, at least these four things.
Shri Radha Krishna ji bajaye, ek varishtha gandhivadi to hain hi, ve ek shreshtha swatantrata senani bhi hain. उन्होंने असहयोग आंदोलन तथा जयपुर सत्याग्रह में सक्रिय भाग लिया। छोटी उम्र में ही उन्हें विनोबा जी का प्रेरक मार्गदर्शन प्राप्त हो गया था। भारत छोड़ो आंदोलन के दौरान राज के विरुद्ध विध्वंसक कार्रवाई जैसे गंभीर आरोप लगाकर उन्हें मृत्युदंड सुना दिया गया। यह मुकदमा उस घटनापूर्व राष्ट्रीय दौड़ के प्रमुख मुकदमों में से एक माना जाता था। राधा कृष्ण जी जीवन भर रचनात्मक कार्यों से संबंधित सब तरह की गतिविधियों में संलग्न रहे हैं। ग्राम विकास कार्य के अंतर्गत उन्होंने वर्धा जिले के गांवों में कुटीर उद्योग आंदोलन के प्रसार का कार्य किया। विनोबा जी का ग्राम सेवा मंडल इसका केंद्र बिंदु था। समय समय पर सचिव, कार्याधिकारी, ट्रस्टी एवं अध्यक्ष के रूप में राधा कृष्ण जी ने इस मंडल को समक्ष तरीके चलाए, सक्षम तरीके से चलाते रहे। एक कार्यकर्ता के रूप में सर्वोदय आंदोलन के प्रति राधा कृष्ण जी की प्रतिबद्धता सदैव संपूर्ण रही। सर्वसेवा संघ के प्रबंधक न्यासी के रूप में उन्होंने इस संस्था के आर्थिक पक्ष का पूर्ण दायित्व तो संभाला। भूदान, ग्रामदान, संपत्ति दान एवं ग्राम स्वराज्य आंदोलन से वे बड़ी गहराई से जुड़े रहे।
अभी मेरे मन में फिलहाल जो विचार सतत चल रहा है उसे आपके सामने रखना चाहता हूँ। हरित क्रांति के नाम से पश्चिम की संस्कृति से जो भी चीजें आई उन्होंने शुरू में चमत्कार दिखाया, उपज बढ़ाई। किसान के जीवन में रासायनिक खाद, कीटनाशक और ट्रैक्टर, ये तीन चीजें दाखिल हुई। शुरू में उन्नति हुई लेकिन पिछले 20 सालों से उनकी कमियां तीव्रता से प्रकट होने लगी। सर्वत्र जहर फैल रहा है, किसान का खर्च बढ़ गया है, जमीन बंजर हो रही है, भूमि इतनी कड़ी होने से वर्षा का पानी भूमि के भीतर न जाकर बेकार रह जाता है। इससे भूमि के जल का स्टॉक कम हो गया है, भूमि की मलाई बाढ़ में बह जाती है और किसान बेचारे आत्महत्या तक पहुँच जाते हैं। अन्न में हवा में पानी में वस्त्र में जहर घुलने के कारण मानव की जीवनी शक्ति घटी है। पवित्र गंगा जल भी विषैला बन गया है और इसके कारण देश का पुण्य घट रहा है, पाप बढ़ रहा है, मानव विनाश के नजदीक जा रहा है। मनुष्य को अगर बचाना है तो गाय को बचाना होगा, वृक्षों को और खेती को बचाना होगा। इसमें राज्य शक्ति, पत्रकार आदि की विचार प्रचार शक्ति और लक्ष्मी पुत्रों का धन तथा व्यवहार बुद्धि सब मिलकर इस देश को जहर से बचा सकते हैं।
Since the last 62 years, Mr. Thakur has been relentlessly striving
was uplift of the farming community and has made important contributions in the field of rural development and the conservation of the environment. He, by the government service in Maharashtra, Thakur was in charge of the first pilot integrated area development scheme of Tasgaon in Sangli district. This was the first smallholder block project selected by the government of India and the Reserve Bank for helping small farmers. Shri Thakur also helped the late Shri V.S. Pare to formulate the Employment Guarantee Scheme, which was later legislated into an act by the government of Maharashtra in 1977.
In my submission, the social dimension of the Parivar is no less important. The endeavor is to use knowledge to liberate the humble farmer from an existence of perpetual want. Prosperity with equity was the motto of Professor Dabhalkar, and we are striving to reach to that end. We have demonstrated in Greece with telling success that a holy alliance between Surya Narayan and the green leaf is the key to universal contentment and happiness.
Srimati Sarojini Vardapan has been the president of the Women's Indian Association in Chennai for no less than 30 years. Over this period, it has become a veritable beehive of activities, activities focused totally on bringing greater happiness and meaning into the lives of the less fortunate members of our society, especially women and children. In this work, Srimati Vardapan's gentle, caring, and persuasive ways have drawn scores of women workers, workers who have volunteered to work under her guidance and leadership on a wide variety of socio-economic projects.
I was privileged to take up social service at the age of 18 years when Mahatma Gandhi visited Chennai in connection with the Hindi Prachar Sabha's Silver Jubilee celebrations. I had the unique honor to serve Mahatma for 15 days as a Sevadal volunteer. Gandhiji inspired me so much that I tried to follow some of his philosophies, like using Swadeshi goods, simple living, conducting Sarvodaya prayer, reading Bhagavad Gita and Tulasi Ramayana, how to maintain credibility and accountability in voluntary organizations. I was also fortunate to get training under great women like Dr. Mrs. Margaret Cousins, Dr. Muthulakshmi Reddy, Srimati S. Ambujammal, and Dr. Durgabai Deshmukh. They were my mentors. And coming from an agricultural and freedom fighters family, I took keen interest in rural development, helping women and children.
Ms. Mary Thurgood's easy walk on the path of Gandhian rural upliftment work was facilitated by her birth and nurture in a farmer's family in Denmark. The rustic atmosphere at home and in her native village molded her for the service in rural areas in her later life. After finishing her education and training, she took to social work, teaching and writing, and this has been her life's mission for the last 60 years. As an ardent admirer and a true follower of Mahatma Gandhi and Vinoba Bhave, whose writings she has studied deeply, Ms. Mary Thurgood easily fitted into the Gandhian constructive movement.
The message of Gandhi's non-violence and human values was communicated in the form of lectures, book writing, and cultural performances. I felt it was my duty to arrange this cooperation after having seen all the Gandhian work done by my friends in India. Sometimes I felt walking with these Sabadeus workers that our lives were at stake when we had to cross ice-cold rivers
barefooted after darkness. The strong will of the Gandhians, reflected in my writings, might have inspired many of my own students and others who read my books. I know my books and my talks about my experiences encourage a great number of young girls and boys, and also grown-up citizens of my country, to visit these Gandhian institutions and study more about Gandhi and his philosophy.
How can you diminish and reduce the burdens of someone else or the suffering of someone else unless you have suffered and carried the burdens yourself? Now this is not just sympathy. Sympathy is not in the word of condescension. I believe this is empathy, is entering into the very soul of suffering, wherever it is, and partaking of it, sharing. Ye puraskar manushyata ka puraskar hai, aisa mana. These awards are about dedication, about service, about humanity, about harmony, about goals of human life. And I recall a very beautiful expression from Shakespeare, who wrote Hamlet, as you know. And if you know Hamlet, the whole play takes place in a country called Denmark, from which Miss Thurgood has come. In fact, I found that she comes from very close to the castle, which was the scene of Shakespeare's play Hamlet. But Hamlet represents that sense of indecision. He says, to be or not to be, he is not very clear. All our recipients are people who are clear in their minds. They have the courage of their conviction, and they've lived their lives in the courage of that conviction.
The soul of India lives in its villages, so said Mahatma Gandhi. And so does the vast majority of our awardees. Maithurga, you mentioned that about your being in the village. And many of whom surely could have chosen more comfortable lives. But the passion for humanity have compelled them to become merchants of hope for the underprivileged masses, driving them, guiding them, leading them to build a better future for themselves. As, and that's my sentiment, as we get blessed by my father, Pooja Ramakrishna Ji, who began this journey 27 years ago. Thank you so much.